If not for you, oh God, when the enemy came against us, he would have destroyed us. Oh, Sike Makanabaya, for your name is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. Lord, we bless you. We glorify you. We honor you. We adore you. We thank you. Siba Kalama. Siboromondo, Sikrendo, Skirabashakaya. Manekonde Bahaste Patuna. Livatom Ratom Belikastom Lekishte Maha. Sikete Makuna Masima Konana Kinanesto Prashta Paha. Shakabalama, Keramonda Flatikista. Siboromondo, Skiash Sekia. We worship you, Lord, we worship you. Bless the name of the Lord. Come on, bless his holy name. He's worthy to be praised and adored. Oh, Shike Baharamash. The presence of God is so strong in this place. Oh, Kashi Bahar. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah to your name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we welcome your awesome presence into our midst tonight. Even as we're gathered here tonight to hear your word, to be lifted by you and to be transformed by you. Lord God, we ask that you inform us by your spirit. You reform us by your spirit. You transform us by your spirit. And Lord, you regenerate us by your spirit. Thank you, Father. Let no one leave this place the same. Let everyone in this place be transformed. Even as we eat from the bread from heaven. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes. Turn to the person next to you and welcome that person to church. Turn to another person and say you're welcome to church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You may have your seat. Praise God. Hallelujah. How was your day? Or how has your day been so far? Because the day is not over yet. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Where is Sister Cynthia? How are you? Have you felt those pains again? They didn't come back. Praise God. What about you, Sister Bess? You're fine. Did you feel the pain again? No. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is doing something mighty in our midst. Praise the Lord. Things are happening in our midst. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How many of you were in church on Sunday? How many of you were here on Sunday? On Sunday you were here. Praise God. How many of you saw what happened on Sunday? What did you see? Who wants to tell me? One person, just one. Who wants to tell me what happened, what you saw? Who wants to say? Nobody, huh? How many of you saw? Raise them up. Okay, put them down. How many, who wants to tell me what you saw briefly? People are embarrassing me, eh? Is this how we do? Just how many are here and you're doing like this? So when we are 10,000, how will you do? Huh? God bless you. Come, let me give you a special blessing before you talk. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, if it is true that you sent me, Shiba Kala Mahaya Masiki Bahata Mas Libronishka. Thank you, Lord. Something has changed in your life. Something has changed. And you begin to see it. Thank you, Lord. Learn to respond. You never know. You never know. Go ahead. Thank you, Lord. It's working. Okay, no, it's not on. Put it on.
Praise the Lord. Well, everything about the service was wonderful, but it all changed when it was time for the communion service. We saw what the bread and what the wine can do physically, in a demonstration that we have never seen before. Yes, we've been learning what the body of Jesus Christ can do and what the blood of Jesus Christ can do, but we actually saw it in action. I don't really know how to explain it, but it was really wonderful what the Holy Communion can do. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. One thing I'll tell you, learn to be bold. Praise the Lord. Learn to be bold. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Learn to be bold. God has not given us a spirit of timidity. If you're not bold, then you need deliverance. Praise the Lord. Learn to be bold. Raise your hand. Let pastor say, no, I'm not you. Are you hearing me? If they call you, then go. Praise the Lord. You see, you don't know who God wants to use. There is a word. Sometimes it's not the pastor that God will put every word in his mouth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God can choose anybody. That's why I always say, when you come to church, when you come to church, come prepared. Come to give. Don't only be a collector. Do you understand? A church is supposed to be a military base. Do you understand? When we are in babyhood stage, that's when it's a hospital. Do you understand? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When we are in the babyhood stage, that's when the church is a hospital. But when we get to certain levels, it becomes a military base. So we have tough and mighty men, mighty warriors. All of them seated in the congregation, ready to give out if they are offered the opportunity. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And of course, we always have newcomers. So those ones are the recruits that you have in the army. That's what church should be. Praise the Lord. Every one of you should be on fire. The same things that we do, every one of you should be able to do them. That's what church is supposed to be. I told you a long time ago, and I still maintain that standing. My goal is not to come and be a superstar before you. That's not the goal. My goal is to make you superstars. Praise the Lord. Some of you are already getting into that line. Some of you already started doing things already. Hallelujah. But my desire is for everyone who is willing. And I always say, don't come to a place like this and see the kind of things that you are seeing and go away and live like you didn't see, because God will use it against you. I told you something. See, the words that we speak in this place, every word I say here, what I say here, I mean it. Praise the Lord. I said something on Sunday while all that was going on. I said, if you leave this place and you don't go and testify about what you saw, I was talking on Sunday, I said this. I said, it will be used against you on Judgment Day. I mean it. If God chose to come down from heaven to grace us with his presence, and you treat such presence with levity, it will be used against you. Don't allow sentiments and certain things to make you resist the power of God. The Bible says, you through your traditions, you have made the word of God of none effect. Praise the Lord. I mean every word. Every word. Hallelujah. You were privileged. Do you know, God was speaking to me, was it on Saturday? Was it Saturday? Some days ago, anyway, he was talking to me and he said something. He said, son, do you know that the days that you are in today, it's better than the days of the apostles, the early church? I said, excuse me, Lord, what are you saying? I said, Lord, what are you talking about? That our day is better than the apostles. Do you know Peter? Lord, I was talking to him. I said, do you know Peter? Peter is the one who was walking on his shadow. Healed the sick. What about Paul, the apostle? The Bible says handkerchiefs and aprons were taken from the body of Paul. And sick people were healed. Mighty miracles happened. The Bible says God wrought special miracles. You know, a miracle alone is good enough. But when God says special miracles, brother, that is something. God performed special miracles by the hand of Paul. Special ones, not ordinary. Praise the Lord. So I was like, Lord, what about Paul? What about Peter? I know what he said to me. He said, yes, they were great men, but I'm not stupid to bring the best of the best first. Do you understand? No, I always bring my best last. Do you understand? The times that we are in are more evil than the days of Paul. How many of you agree with that? In their days, they didn't have pornography. They didn't have clubs like we have them today. They didn't have many sins and internet and all kind of things that people... In fact, it's so easier right now to be infiltrated with sin nowadays. You do something as small as this, you can fill yourself with junk. Connected to the internet, oh, when I was a very little, when I was very young, we had one black and white TV, it was a box. How many of you know that thing? The older people will know, black and white, God bless you. And then you do it like this to change the channel, cap. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That was what we had then. But today, on the small device, your small phone, you can watch anything you want to watch. Praise the Lord. That's how the world has become today. Praise the Lord. A family, a business, a company, a Christian company in Ireland was being charged. They are being charged and fined because they refused to bake a cake and write on the cake, support gay marriage. They say they're not making that cake because they are Christians and their Christian faith doesn't allow them. And they were taken to court and the court fined them about $800 for that. Their crime was that they discriminated against whatever. Praise the Lord. That's the world that we're in. Years ago, you couldn't even come out and say, I am this.
Praise the Lord. But now with impunity, that's the world that we live in today. So if God brought us at this time, it's because there is something about us. Because the Bible says, where sin abounds, grace abounds much more. Hallelujah. And guess what? I tell you the truth, Africa is the next big thing. Praise the Lord. I said Africa is the next big thing. Don't look at what you are seeing. All these things are deceptive. Africa is the next big thing. Why am I saying that? Look at it. Where is the most underdeveloped part of the world? Huh? Where is the most spiritual place? When I say spiritual, negative. Africa. If you want juju, all kinds and all type, go to Africa. I know there's one place called India that is also contesting with Africa. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But Africa. And so what? The ministers that God raises from those places, from places like that, they are fierce warriors. Do you understand? Fierce warriors. If you look at the ministers today, the ones who are doing the mightiest things around the world, check them, Africans. Praise the Lord. In Africa right now, to say there is a miracle in your church is not the news. It's the caliber of miracles that people want to know. Praise the Lord. It's the caliber of miracles that people want to know. Hallelujah. But you see some places, some churches in Europe and in other Western places. Church service, 30 minutes. 30 minutes is longer than 30 minutes. Some people will be even showing the priest time. Praise the Lord. Somebody will collapse inside hospital. They will call inside church. They will call ambulance to come and carry the person. Without first praying at least. It's not a sin to call ambulance. The doctors have their role. Do you understand? But why will you come and choose to die in my presence? Huh? No, not here. If you want to collapse, not inside church. Except his judgment. That one is different. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But you see, God was telling me, he says the day that you are in is greater than the days. After all, the Bible says the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the... Of course. The battle is becoming fiercer and fiercer. Do you understand? It's becoming fiercer and fiercer. I feel sorry for you if you are sleeping. I feel sorry for you if you are sleeping. If you don't know that you are in a battle, you are already defeated. You are waiting for your day of destruction. If you don't know that you're in a battle, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, we wake up in the morning and we just go about our normal business like normal people. The Bible says, I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. He said, but you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes because you don't know. Neither do you understand. Praise the Lord. Let's open our Bibles. Psalm 82. From verse 5. Now watch this. It says, they know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. What is darkness? What is darkness? Darkness is the absence of light. Am I correct? The Bible says God is a father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, nor shadow of turning. He is a father of lights. Praise God. Hallelujah. God is the father of lights. And so the absence of God is darkness. So in every area of your life that God is not present, you're walking in darkness. Praise the Lord. He says, they know not, neither do they understand. So it's possible for you to be born again, yet you are walking in darkness. It's possible for you to say, I'm a Christian, but you are walking in darkness. Hallelujah. It's very possible. He says, they know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness, All the foundations of the earth are out of course. Verse 6, it says, I have said, you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. Now, he's not talking to everyone. Are you hearing me? Everyone is not a god. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Everyone is not a god. He's talking about those who have received Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. I'll prove it in a minute. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If a goat gives birth, what will it give birth to? It will give birth to a goat. If a dog gives birth, it will give birth to... If an elephant gives birth, it will give birth to what? If a lion gives birth, it will give birth to what? If God gives birth, what will he give birth to? He will give birth to gods. That's why I said, I have said, you are gods. And all of you, he's talking to a particular people. All of you, he's not talking about the whole world. I'll show you in a minute. All of you, he says, are children of the Most High. Now let's go to the book of John chapter 10. Quickly, we'll come back to this Psalm scripture. John chapter 10. Verse 34. Quickly, because we're coming back to this scripture. Now watch this. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now 35 is the big one. He went on to explain what God was saying in the Psalms there. He says, if he called them gods, unto whom the word of God came, and the scriptures cannot be broken. Did you see that? Those who is calling God are those who the word of God came and they received. That's who is calling God. The day the message of Jesus Christ came, you received that message into your spirit. That message made you born again. That message made you become like your heavenly Father. I told you last week, I said when we are calling God Heavenly Father, if he has to call us, he calls us heavenly children. Hallelujah. That's what he calls us. Till I have said, you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High God. Now let's go back to that Psalm scripture. I'll read verse 6 again. Psalm 82 verse 6. He says, I have said, you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. But look at verse 7. It says, but you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Did you see that? Don't ignore, the whole Bible is complete, it's full. He says, I have said you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. But you shall die like men and suffer like the princes. Like one of the princes. You will suffer. He said, you will suffer like men. You will be hungry like men. You will be broke like men. Why? He answered this thing in verse 5. He said, because they know not, neither would they understand. So they walk on in darkness. When we are telling you, I saw one, it was like a cartoon somebody did on Facebook, I saw. And they put, it was like a rail, it was a bar or something. And somebody was told, don't cross the laws of God. These are the laws of God. Don't cross. And the person said, no, I cannot be held by any law. And he jumped over. And as he jumped over, he was going, ooh, I said, sorry, I forgot to tell you that there are also rails for your protection. When you are told, don't do this, don't do that, it's not because anybody wants to put you on that law. It's not because anybody wants to put you in bondage. These are rails for your protection. Praise the Lord. When we say come to church, when we say come to church, we have service on Wednesday, come on Wednesday. We have service on Sunday, come to church. We are not telling you because we want to see your face or your faces. No, it's for your protection. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. We're praying for a sister and this demon began to manifest. And I was talking and I said something and I said, mention the name Jesus. And he screamed, ah, don't mention that name, don't mention that name. I don't want to hear the name Jesus. I don't want to hear that name. And then I, in process, I mentioned, I said, Do you like JICC? Say, ah, no, 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 I don't like the other name. Don't mention that name, JICC. I don't want to hear JICC. I hate JICC. I don't want to hear the name JICC. Why was the reaction when we called the name of Jesus and the name JICC? Why was the reaction the same? The same reaction, exactly the same. Why? Because JICC is not separate from Jesus. Do you understand? Praise the Lord. If I told you to touch me now, come forward. Touch me. Come and touch my body. Praise the Lord. You see what he did? What did I tell him to do? Huh? To touch what? What? I told him to touch my body. And what did he do? He touched what? He touched my right hand. Did he do what I asked him to do? Huh? Did he do what I asked him to do? How many of you say yes? How many of you say no? Hallelujah. God bless you. You can have a seat. Praise the Lord. I told him to, it's my heart, not my body. It's all I'm the same fine. If I ask him, who did you touch? He will say you touched Pastor Isaac, right? But it was my hand he touched. Which means my hand and me are one and the same. If you touch my hand, you touched me. Hallelujah. And then the light shine from heaven, brighter than the morning sun. Paul and his friends were going to Damascus to go and persecute the Christians. And that light shone from heaven and knocked Paul down from that horse. And then he heard a voice, Paul, why are you persecuting me? He didn't say, why are you persecuting my church? He says, why are you persecuting me? It is hard to kick against the pricks. Hallelujah! Paul never met Jesus physically at one time, at any time in his life. Praise the Lord! But when Jesus showed up, he said, why are you persecuting me? He didn't say my church. Because my church and I are one and the same. Do you understand? So when I say JICC is bigger than me, now you understand. There's something I used to say before. I regret, I repent. I won't say it again. I used to say the anointing that I carry is not for me. That was a big mistake. I didn't know that. Now I know. Yesterday I was feeling pain. When I woke up in the morning, I was feeling pain in my back. I don't know how it came. Was it the way I slept or if it was supernatural? I don't know. But these things are normal. I face attacks all the time. And so I took a cup, put water inside, and I said, in the name of Jesus, I felt the anointing enter inside the cup. And I drank it. Immediately I drank it, I fell under the power in my kitchen. I woke up, got up from the floor, back pain has gone. Praise the Lord. So I was like, wow. So even me too, there's protection for me. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I said, JICC is bigger than Isaac Samuel. It's bigger than me. Praise the Lord. Oh, yes, it is. It's bigger. Praise the Lord. Now, are we the only part of the body? Of course we are not. There are many other parts doing wonderful things for the Lord, doing great and mighty things for the Lord. But you see, our meeting place is not here on earth. It's in heaven. We will congratulate ourselves. Not here on earth. Here, anytime we're coming together, it's for us to do work. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's for us to work. Is there any time in your life where your left ear and your right ear have had a meeting? Where you took your left ear and you joined it together, they touched. Is it possible? Huh? For that to happen, someone will need to break your head. Am I correct? Break it and turn it around before they can touch. Am I correct? How the body of Christ is. We don't have to meet here. Do you understand? Right now we are busy. The ear should be busy hearing. The eye should be busy seeing. The hand should be busy doing. The leg should be busy walking. The heart should be busy beating. Do you understand? We are busy. Because we are the body of Christ. And we all have been apportioned our roles in the work. In this end time army, Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, I cannot speak for any other commission, but I can speak for JICC because I know. Hallelujah. I know. Now, God has said something on Wednesday. I said the month of June is the month of regeneration. And here in JICC, there are so many other places they just say, but me, I like to prove the word. How many of you, your faith was lifted on Sunday when you saw everything that happened? Your faith was lifted. Let me tell you what would have happened. When that demon, that spirit, it was Lucifer. When he was in control over that sister, she charged towards me and was trying to get her finger to break my finger. Now, let me tell you, if she had succeeded in doing that, and we, because breaking of bone is very painful, huh? What will happen? I tell you the truth, by next Sunday, half of church will not come. Half of church will not come by next Sunday. Praise the Lord. I'm like, man, this one is let me go to my simple church. Holy, 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 amen. Pastor Isaac is taking this thing too far. Praise the Lord. But when we gained the victory and she got up and she said the back pain is gone. Whoa, glory to God. Now you know that what we're talking about is real. Brothers and sisters, if God didn't send me, I would have been in for big soup. That's for sure. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said something before. I said he fends the one he sends. Who he sends, he tends. And he fends. And he defends. Hallelujah. God defended me because he sent me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible says, I have said you are gods. And all of you are children of the Most High. But you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Because you don't know who you are. When we say, I know who I am. Do you really know who you are? Most of you, many of you don't know. If you knew who you are, you would not be walking and talking the way you talk. Can you be outside and somebody sees you and tells the difference between you and someone who is not of God? Can they tell the difference? Can they tell the difference? Can people hear you talk and say, this one is a servant of God? Can they hear you? How do you carry yourself outside? Who are you? So they shall die like men and fall like one of the princes because they don't know who they are. Praise the Lord. I watched one of the a movie talked about one of the French. What happened when the French monarchy was still on? And there was a set of twins, two brothers, that were born to the king. And the rightful one was taken and hidden somewhere away when he was very little. And then the other one, a wicked brother, was on the throne doing many wicked things. And so a group of people went and got that guy. When they first got him, he didn't even know he was royalty. He didn't know who he was. And so those guys had to educate him and tell him more about who he was. They taught him how to live like a prince, how to eat, how to use a sword. They taught him all those things before they took him to the palace. And eventually he became king. And he was a very good king. Praise the Lord. When you don't know who you are, you will struggle. You will suffer like other people. The things that other people go through, you will go through them. Hallelujah. You think, but you have to get up and be different. I'm like those men who educated that king. My job is to educate you and tell you more about who you are. And when you know, you get up and you take your position. Are you still fascinated by the things of this world? The fashion of this world, the music of this world. You listen to all those junk and all those dirty things. You're watching that movie, when it gets to the sex part, you glue your eyes to the TV. And you're watching, you're congested, taking the whole thing. You shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Listen, there is no fence for you to stand. You are either for God or you are for the devil. And there are many people who call themselves Christians who are for the devil. Praise the Lord. That's just it. Let me tell you something. Those who will make it to heaven are those who have their white garments without stain. The Bible says he's coming for a church without spots, without wrinkles, or any such thing.
Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are you clean and spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you
born again, and the moment you are born again, your garment is changed. You receive a white garment. But somewhere along the line, stains come on that garment. Sometimes these stains are not something that you take and put on yourself. But you must be careful to make sure that garment is washed. That's why the blood of Jesus is available today. The blood of Jesus is not only available for those who are not born again. Is available for you that are a Christian. You that have received Jesus is also there for you. The only detergent that can wash off the stain of sin is the blood of Jesus Christ. And even us that are born again, we need it. The Bible says there are three that bear witness in the earth: the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. The blood is in the earth. So says your Bible. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And so if at any time you find out you've done something wrong, quickly go and have a bath. The blood of Jesus. We're praying for somebody on Sunday. And I wanted to, this thing many times, I don't just do things, I like to teach. And I stretched my hand, I said, the blood of Jesus. You saw the reaction. And I quoted from that scripture, the Bible says Moses took a hyssop branch and he took the blood of the lamb and he took the hyssop branch and dipped inside the blood and was sprinkling it on everything. What they use in the Old Testament to sanctify. The blood of Jesus Christ is a sanctifying agent. Hallelujah. And so we have it available today. Not the physical blood. In the spirit, we can take that blood. Do you understand? In the spirit we can. And we can use it. Hallelujah. We can use it. I told somebody once, was it Kenneth Hagin who was saying it? Kenneth Hagin said something. He said, don't argue with results. When you see someone who has results, come go and ask questions. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me tell you something. What we have come into is not a thing of games, fun and games. It is life. Do you understand? It is life eternal that we have come into. It's something real. We're praying for that sister. And she said, Isaac Samuel, why are you troubling us? Why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? I said, do you know my name? I said, she said, of course. The demon said, of course, we know you. You are very popular. I said, popular where? Because as I can see, church. How many of us are in this church? I said, no, in our place, you are popular. Now I say, where is your place? Said hell. If you did not believe that hell existed before, when you hear such things, you should believe. Praise the Lord. You should believe. If you didn't believe before, to hell. That's our place. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. These things are real. So I told her, I said, we are not in a thing of fun and games. It is life. It is real stuff. If you do the words that we ask you to do, brothers and sisters, you are protected. No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. This is what I was preaching here on Sunday. If you notice, the message on Sunday was in two parts. The first, I was just prophesying. And I said, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. I said, let them take you to Sangoma. The first time they tried, let them try it again. I was prophesying. That's exactly what happened to spirit. Because they went again. Do you understand? I was prophesying. I was prophesying. That's to let you know that we were battle ready. Do you understand? Let me tell you, if you are in this place, you call JICC your home, your church, relax, you are protected. Hallelujah. You see, when it's time for you to pray, pray. Do you understand? Pray, but also know I'm praying for you. Do you understand? I'm praying for you. Hey, something comes into your room. Fear, everything. Pastor Isaac says he's praying for me. Relax. Just go back to sleep. Go to sleep. Hallelujah. Go to sleep. In the past how many days we've had testimonies upon testimonies. Now I don't know how to share them again. Today I received a message from a lady that been married for years, no baby. She said, Pastor, it has happened. I've not shared that one. I've not shared it. Praise the Lord. Somebody called me yesterday. Her brother was involved in an accident far away in Cameroon. Terrible accident. So he was internal bleeding. He had gone into a coma. He was dying. I said, relax. No. This guy is not going anywhere. Go away. And maybe I didn't pray a long prayer. Short prayer. Shiba kala makaya. Shibo bo 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 bo. Karus. Died away. No chance. Shiba. Ayamakabala. Simo Mose. Let me tell you something. I didn't ask God to choose me. Do you understand? I didn't tell him to choose me. I was on my own when he chose me. Do you understand? So I have nothing to do with this. It's the grace of God. That's why we cannot boast about it. I always tell God, I say, Lord, you see, they didn't say praise Isaac, they say praise Jesus or praise God. To you be all the glory. Hallelujah. I say, if you are in JICC, you call this place your home, you are protected. You are secure. On Sunday, I was prophesying. All that time, I was prophesying. I was just prophesying. At a point, I was like, what's wrong with you? You're supposed to be telling me about regeneration. What are you doing? So if you notice, I just stopped abruptly and started talking about the theme of the month. How many of you remember that? That's exactly what happened. I was prophesying. Because in the spirit, I have seen what was coming and I was ready. So at every time I was waiting to hear what next to do. When it was time for communion, ordinarily we just take, no, bring it forward. Stretch your hands over it. And I said every prophecy that I spoke today on Sunday, I've put it inside this bread. Every prophecy. Eat it. Everyone who ate it. I was, after the service, some of you had left, were praying for that sister. And I asked that demon, I said, look, why don't you want her to eat this thing? Because he said, if she eats it, she will have transformation. And I don't want it. I said, wait, those people who eat this bread, what will happen in their life? He said, transformation. I said, okay, what about their family members that are not here? Those who ate it on behalf of their family members, what will happen? He said, connection. Hallelujah. So listen, your family is protected because of what you are doing. Praise the Lord. There is security here. There is protection here. There is God here. He's here. Hallelujah. Listen, brothers and sisters. We have, the Bible says, a more sure word of prophecy. Sibakaya. Open 2 Peter chapter 1. Shaboro boromondosh. Shiba ba 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 ba. Sampuru gushta. Verse 16. Now watch this carefully. This thing that Peter wrote here, I'm also saying it. So take it like it's Isaac that is saying it. He said, for we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty. Say, for he received from God the Father honor and glory. When there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. And this voice which came from heaven, we heard when we were with him in the Holy Mount. Now, Peter is talking of his personal experience. This is one of the reasons why God told me, he said, our day is better than their day. Most of what they had is because of what they saw with their eyes physically. He said, but you have not seen, yet you believe so much with your life. I was watching a video of what happened when that sister was coming, and the ushers went to her. I said, ushers, no, wait. This is mine. Praise the Lord. This is mine. Because if that didn't happen, it will be a battle that I'll fight in the future. It was a test of my belief on the name of Jesus Christ. Do you understand? It was a test of my faith on that name. And I was watching. The moment everything changed was when I said something. I said, I trust the name of Jesus. It has never failed me before. Once I mentioned that pump, the devil would win now. That was it. Hallelujah. Praise God. I tell you the truth, you can be in a life-threatening situation. That same name will save you. Praise the Lord. God said most of what they had was because of what they saw with their optical eyes. He said, but you did not see. You have not seen. You were not there. Yet you believe so much with your life. Hallelujah. One day, Jesus took three of his disciples, Peter, James, and John, up to the mountain. What we refer to as the mountain of transfiguration. And the Bible says he was changed before them. And he began to glow. He was glowing, shining. And then the voice from heaven came and said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. Hallelujah. And Peter and the rest, they were afraid. They were there. That's what he's talking about. And Jesus took them that day. I'm sure that experience, he had it several times. He took them that day just so there will be witnesses. Just like you people are witnesses of the thing that God is doing here. Hallelujah. Verse 19. So we have also a more sure word of prophecy. Whereunto you do well that you take heed as unto a light that shineth in a dark place until the day dawn and the day star arise in your heart. Hallelujah. He says, beyond that, so we have a more sure word of prophecy. What is that word that God has spoken to you personally? Do you understand? What has God said to you? See, that your Bible is not a furniture. It's for you to use. Get specific words from God's word that he has spoken to you. Take those words and claim them. Make them yours. That day when that thing was happening, as I was saying to that, he said, God told me in Joshua chapter 1 verse 5, he said, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. A more sure word of prophecy. So even when it looked like darkness was prevailing, I held on to that word. Held on to that word until the day dawned, the day star appeared, darkness was gone. In your life, you must have that word of prophecy. What has God spoken to you? For example, do you know that we said June is a month of regeneration? Do you know that it is God speaking to you? It's the word of God. I showed you from the Bible. Titus chapter 3. This is the washing of regeneration and the renewing of the Holy Ghost. That's the word of God. So when it looks like everything in your life is finished, say, devil, regeneration, the washing of regeneration, the renewing of the Holy Ghost. My bank account is being renewed. My mind is being renewed. My family is being renewed. The washing of regeneration, a more sure word of prophecy. When darkness comes and the devil is trying to fight so hard, things are happening. Hold on to that word. The Bible says, and having done all to stand. Are we here or we're not here? I'm seeing some very, very important spiritual things. Are you receiving or you're just here? The Bible says we have a more sure word of prophecy. And we have to hold on to that word. The Bible says fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. God's word is eternal life. He said, my son, pay attention to my word, for they are life to those who find them. God's word is eternal. When he says lay hold on eternal life, he's talking about the word of God. 1 Timothy chapter 6. Verse 12. Thank you, Lord. Sibo Orabakaya. Shiba Baba 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 Baba. Verse 12. Before the first word there.
No, you can't be fighting and saying I fight.
I will fight you. What the first word there?
Fight.
That's it. Fight. He says, fight the good fight of faith. I told you before, I said, if you don't know that you are in a battle, you're already defeated. If you do not know that you are in a battle, you're already defeated. Say, they shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. They are living their lives like everyone else. They are going to the club like everyone else. They are having boyfriends and girlfriends like everyone else. You will die like men. Cancer is coming. Coming, it's at the door. What did Jesus tell Peter? He says, Peter, Satan has asked of you that he may sift you as wheat. Say, but I have prayed for you that your faith not fail. It's my prayer that brought you here tonight to hear this word. Will you change? Will there be a change in your life, or will you still be the same? God, I was always going to church Sunday, Wednesday. He said, I know you not. Depart from me, you worker of iniquity. You are a worker of iniquity. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He says, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Whereunto thou art called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. He says, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Hold fast to eternal life. He says, we have a more sure word of prophecy. Whereunto we stand, we hold on to that word. Hallelujah. He says, we have not fully calling the vice tables. Verse 17. Verse 18. 19. So I'm talking of 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 1 from verse 18, from 19. It says, we have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in the dark place, until the day dawn. He said, take heed. Now must hold on to that word, even when you are in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star appears in your heart, until you get the victory. Hold fast to that word. What is the word that you are holding on to? Book of Proverbs chapter 4. Proverbs chapter 4. Thank you, Lord. Mokaya. Verse 20. Shamakaya. Simarama. Tibohola Bahaya. Shambohola Hati Masi. A more sure word of prophecy. A more sure word of prophecy. What do you have? What word are you holding on to? What word is your life built on? My son, attend to my words. Attend to my words. Incline your ears unto my sayings. Attend to my word. He says, let them not depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart. That moment you are watching pornography, the word has departed from your eyes. He says, for they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. He says the word of God is life to those who find them, which means not everyone, which means the word is scarce. Do you understand? You don't find, do you know how many people look for air? Huh? How many people take time to look for air? It's everywhere. Am I correct? He says, they are lies to those that find them, which means it's a scarce commodity. And health to all their flesh. The word of God is a scarce commodity. There are many churches today, places that are called churches, but there are not many places where the eternal word is released. Ancient word is released. It's not many, there are few. The Bible says many are called, but few are chosen. So, these categories, which one do you choose? Those who are just called but refuse to answer, or those who are chosen because they answer the call? What do you choose? Where is your position? Where is your stand in God? You're still playing hanky-panky, one leg in, one leg out, as if sickness is at the door. It's at the door. Look at it. I didn't lie. I'm not cursing you. Look at it in your Bible. It says, my word is life to those who find them. With these those who don't find them, what do they have? That's it. And then it says, health to all their flesh. Which means if you don't find it, death and sickness. Open Psalm 107. Verse 17. I said, a more sure word. Are you there? Look, I didn't write the Bible. Look. It says, fools. Because of their transgression and because of their iniquities are afflicted. Because of their transgression and because of their iniquities, they are afflicted. You say, but I've been doing this, I've been doing that, nothing has happened. Relax. Go and do a doctor. Go to your doctor. Go and do a check. There are some that microscope will not detect. A lady sent me a message this afternoon. She said, Pastor, so many things have been going on in my life. My mother just died suddenly without warning. She just dropped and died. She didn't complain of sickness, nothing, just dropped. That's all. The Bible says when they say peace, peace, sudden destruction comes. Praise the Lord. It says fools, because of their transgression and because of their iniquity, are afflicted. Their soul abhorreth all manner of meat, and they draw near unto the gates of death. I told you, sin, sickness, and death. Sin will bring sickness, which will eventually bring death. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Verse 19 says, then they cry unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saveth them out of their distress. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. That destruction is talking about, he's talking about demons. Do you understand? He healed them and delivered. You see two things here. Healed and delivered. He sent his word and healed. And most times, God's word is transported. There's a conveyor. There's someone who conveys the word. That's why people like us come in. When he said he sent his word, it's through us. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 11, it says, if any man speak, let him speak as an oracle of God. So we speak as oracles of God. We are conveyors of God's word. Yes, I know it's a mistake that put you in that level. But God sent me. Heal you and to deliver you from your destructions. But after that, we will also warn you, don't go back. Don't go back. Like Jesus told that man, said, go and sin no more. You are healed today. Go and sin no more. Lest a worse thing happen. And then he said, this evil generation is, I liken this evil generation like a situation where a demon was in a place and then he's cast out. The Lord is standing right there. Right there. Right there. White. Cure. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Krabashaka. Aya. Aya. Oh, glory to God. What's going to happen tonight? Aya, Baba, Baba, Baba. Sibala, Baya. Sibala, Mosh. Kabala, Baya. Ah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Shakubala. Kidashibata. Aya. Kribala. Just next 1 minute, just rise up to your feet. Next 1 minute. And receive his presence. Say, Lord, I receive your presence. The Lord said there's a work he didn't finish on Sunday, which he wants to finish now. There's someone who was supposed to touch in a special way. But he didn't touch you on Sunday, and he came for you. Listen, God is always present in our meetings. But at the time when he shows up in the way that he has shown up now, he came for something. Sibo Kola. Just look at this. Say, Lord, I receive your presence.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Help me sing it.
Break every chain. There's an army rising up. There's an army.
But I pray for those who are watching right now. I pray for them. Lord, let that same anointing in this place be present where they are. In the name of Jesus Christ, let your power be upon them. Whatever the enemy is doing in their lives, causing destruction, causing sickness, I command a reverse. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Somebody give the Lord a hand of praise.